Advanced Practice Registered Nurse, Wikipedia Article Audio. An Advanced Practice Registered Nurse is a nurse with postgraduate education in nursing. APRNs are prepared with advanced didactic and clinical education, knowledge, skills, and scope of practice in nursing. APRN defines a level of nursing practice that utilizes extended and expanded skills, experience, and knowledge in assessment, planning, implementation, diagnosis and evaluation of the care required. Nurses practicing at this level are educationally prepared at the postgraduate level and may work in either a specialist or generalist capacity. However, the basis of advanced practice is the high degree of knowledge, skill, and experience that is applied within the nurse-patient/client relationship to achieve optimal outcomes through critical analysis, problem-solving and evidence-based decision-making. Education, accreditation, and certification. Grandfather exception. APRNs demonstrate effective integration of theory, practice, and experiences along with increasing degrees of autonomy in judgments and interventions. Intensive postgraduate education is designed to teach an APRN to use multiple approaches to decision-making, manage the care of individuals and groups, engage in collaborative practices with the patient or client to achieve best outcomes, provide a supportive environment for colleagues, manage the utilization of staff and physical resources, engage in ethically justifiable nursing practice, protect the rights of individuals and groups, engage in activities to improve nursing practice, develop therapeutic and caring relationships, fulfill the conduct requirements of the profession, act to enhance the professional development of self, and function in accordance with legislation and common law affecting nursing practice. APRN education forms the basis of four recognized general areas of specialization. Each nurse specialty, especially NPS, can have subspecialties or concentrations in a specific field or patient population in healthcare. Each has a unique history and context, but shares the commonality of being an APRN. While education, accreditation, and certification are necessary components of an overall approach to preparing an APRN for practice, these roles are regulated by legislation and specific professional regulation. This allows for prescribing and referral, insurance reimbursement, and admitting privileges to healthcare facilities. In the U.S., the licensing boards are governed by state regulations and statutes and are the final arbiters of who is recognized to practice within a given state. While APRNs are educated differently depending on their specific specialty, all APRNs are now trained at the graduate level and are required to attain at least a master's degree, generally a Master of Science in Nursing in their field of concentration. In 2004, the American Association of Colleges of Nursing in conjunction with the National Council of State Boards of Nursing recommended that advanced practice registered nurses move the entry-level degree to the doctorate level by 2015. Accordingly, all APRN training programs are recommended to convert their master's degree to a Doctor of Nursing Practice degree by the year 2015. Although the American Association of Nurse Anesthetists approved this recommendation, it is not requiring program compliance until the year 2025. Patient outcomes. The majority of programs will grant a DNP. Because 45% of the nurse anesthesia programs are located in schools of allied health, these programs will award a Doctor of Nurse Anesthesia Practice. The DNP will be the direct entry, minimum academic requirement for advanced practice registered nurses, it is a clinical/practice-based doctorate, but because it is not the entry degree for the profession of nursing, it is a terminal degree. Every state has different laws, rules, regulations, licensing and certification requirements for advanced practice registered nurses, thus some states may not have a grandfather clause in their state board of nursing laws, in particular as it may relate to transferring a license from one state to another. The U.S. National Council of State Boards of Nursing continues to work on a collaborative multi-state compact licensure agreement for advanced practice nurses to be able to work in multiple U.S. states with a singular active home state license. There are ongoing discussions on expanding that type of licensure nationally, similar to the existing Nurse Licensure Compact for recognition of RN and LPN licenses. Terminal degrees. Numerous studies have been conducted comparing the patient outcomes of care provided by APRNs and physicians. The conclusions reached indicate that outcomes of care by APRNs in collaboration with physicians is comparable, and in some instances better, than care by a physician alone. A recent systematic review concluded that APRN care is safe, cost-effective, and results in similar clinical outcomes and patient satisfaction as compared to care by physicians alone for the populations and in the settings included in the studies. This review did not include data on CRNAs as no outcomes met the criteria for aggregation. The review was supported by a grant from the Tri-Council for Nursing and the Advanced Practice Registered Nurse Alliance. No independent reviews have duplicated such findings. An APRN may earn a terminal degree in several ways. A terminal degree is generally a doctorate. In some fields, especially those linked to a profession, a distinction is to be drawn between a first professional degree, an advanced professional degree, and a terminal academic degree. A first professional degree is generally required by law or custom to practice the profession without limitation. An advanced professional degree provides further training in a specialized area of the profession. A first professional degree is an academic degree designed to prepare the holder for a particular career or profession, fields where scholarly research and academic activity are not the work, but rather the practice of a profession. In many cases, the first professional degree is also the terminal degree because usually no further advanced degree is required for practice in that field, even though more advanced professional degrees may exist. Examples of terminal degrees in research are postnominal initials. Examples of terminal professional degrees in nursing are the specific titles, credentials, and postnominal initials used by advanced practice nurses will vary greatly by country, state, and educational level. A list of postnominal initials include, but are not limited to, clinical nurse specialists, nurse anesthetists, nurse midwives, nurse practitioners, doctor of philosophy, doctor of education, doctor of science, doctor of nursing science, doctor of nursing practice, doctor of nurse anesthesia practice, ACNP, acute care nurse practitioner, AGACN, adult gerontology acute care nurse practitioner, ANP, adult nurse practitioner, APHN, advanced public health nurse, APRN, advanced practice registered nurse, APN, advanced practice nurse, ARNP, advanced registered nurse practitioner, C or BC following a title, certified or board certified, CMCN, certified managed care nurse, CNM, certified nurse midwife, CNS, clinical nurse specialist, CRNP, certified registered nurse practitioner, CS, Clinical Specialist, CRNA. Certified Registered Nurse Anesthetist, DNP, Doctor of Nursing Practice, FNP, Family Nurse Practitioner, GNP, Gerontological Nurse Practitioner, NNP, Neonatal Nurse Practitioner, NP, Nurse Practitioner, ONP, Oncology Nurse Practitioner, PMHCNS, Psychiatric and Mental Health Clinical Nurse Specialist, PMHNP, Psychiatric and Mental Health Nurse Practitioner, PNP, Pediatric Nurse Practitioner, PNPAC, Pediatric Nurse Practitioner Acute Care, CINP, Psychiatric Nurse Practitioner, WHNP, Women's Health Nurse Practitioner.